tenía en la cabeza solo el objetivo de triunfar. Llegué con un atrevimiento como el de Romario y diciendo que marcaría 30 goles en la primera temporada, ¿no? Al final, pues sí, marqué 34 goles. Superé la marca que había prometido.
In his playing days, there was hardly any other striker more lethal than Ronaldo Nazario. El Fenomeno. No one could stop him. No one. Not even his crystal knees. A player so phenomenal, so Rare decided to create an R9 legend card to celebrate his 94-95 season. So if you've heard the tales but never saw him in action, this is old school Ronaldo. Ronaldo's first scout was his mother, Doña Sonia. I'm his mother, so it sounds presumptuous to say that he was better than some of his football teammates, but he was, truly. It was obvious that he was a different player. At 6 years old, his talent was already obvious to everyone. The kid, born in Rio de Janeiro in 1976, loved the game and the game loved him back. Ronaldo would play in the streets and passersby would be amazed by his talent. So much so, in fact, they would call football clubs to sign him. Every single club in Rio was behind him. But, as Doña Sonia claims, none of them would want to cover the travel costs for him to join them. Ronaldo would play football all day long, even when he was supposed to be in school. That's when his mom drew the line and forbid him from playing football. All I wanted was for him to be successful in life, and in my head at the time, that meant studying. I wanted him to have a good academic background so that he could have a job he loves. Football, I saw it as a hobby, not as a profession. But Ronaldo's talent was unstoppable. By the age of 12, he joined an indoor club and was spotted by former Brazilian legend Jair Cineo. When he was 13 years old, he was signed by his agents. They rejected offer after offer until Cruzeiro splashed $60,000 on him. After scoring 4 goals in his trial with them, it was unheard of. Ronaldo debuted for Cruzeiro 3 months later, and he was unmissable. The first time I saw him play was at Cruzeiro. He was still a kid. It was in a game where he ended up scoring 5 goals. From that point on, he showed he was truly a phenomenon. Cruzeiro soon felt what Ronaldo's mother had. The kid was impossible to miss. They were rejecting offers while a teenage Ronaldo was bagging goals and producing tricks that impressed anyone who could get a glimpse of Brazilian football. Remember, there was no YouTube back then. Ronaldo scored 44 goals in 47 matches for them before Cruzeiro accepted PSV's $6.3 million offer for the kid. An absolute steal.
Fue mi primer año en Europa, PSV. Ya tenía leyendas brasileñas que había pasado por ahí, como Romario. Llegué con un atrevimiento como el de Romario y diciendo que marcaría 30 goles en la primera temporada. No tenía ni idea de lo que estaba diciendo.
Ronaldo had the impossible task of filling the shoes of the previous Brazilian wonder kid, Romario. In his first 5 seasons at PSV, Romario had become the deadliest striker in the world. When he left Holland for Barcelona, he had scored 128 goals in 149 matches. You can check out his very own old school episode later on. Ronaldo's game was one of speed. He was the new breed of strikers coming out from South America. He could dribble standing still and was a master of the step over that even inspired Cristiano Ronaldo years later. Ronaldo would feint, nutmeg, and destroy any defenders on his way to goal. He would do it all as fast and as graceful as a gazelle. And once in the box, he could finish the play with any type of shot. But when one versus one, Ronaldo had one preferred move, to dribble past the goalie. Ronaldo was the biggest specialist in the art form of putting the goalie to bed and then tapping it into an empty net. Like many Brazilians of the time, Ronaldo's game derived from his joya, literally the joy of his life. Living next to the beach, enjoying the summer breeze and the Ipanema women. Eindhoven was nothing like that.
Lo pasé fatal fuera de campo, porque yo soy carioca y a un país tan frío, sobre todo en invierno como Holanda, fue un shock muy duro para mí. Jugamos con temperaturas de menos 20 grados y durante el invierno, pues el río se congeló y se podía caminar por encima del río. Yo...
While in Rio, at the same time of the year, Ronaldo's goal, however, was to make it in football. Romario told me that PSV is one of the most professional and best organized clubs in Europe. He said it would be best to acclimatize in Europe and learn about European football. I think he is right. On the pitch, there were no difficulties for him. It took 10 minutes in his debut to score his first goal, and in the next game, he got a brace. Ronaldo never stopped scoring. the Dutch League was, once more, proving too small of a place for him. World champion Rudy Feller faced him with Leverkusen, and Ronaldo scored a hat trick. Never in my life have I seen an 18-year-old play in this way. The most striking thing about teenage Ronaldo is that he was complete. His lightning speed, his dribbling, his physicality, and his composure in front of the goal, the traits that defined his entire career, they were all there since day one. That's when Europe decided they all wanted a piece of Ronaldo. After scoring 54 goals in 57 matches, Ronaldo moved to the Camp Nou to, once more, fill in the shoes of Romario. His game took a whole new level. He was physical perfection. He seemed like a mythical figure. I love Messi. I've played many times with Cristiano and I adored him. Neymar's outstanding. Ronaldinho was exceptional. But if you put all of them together, you might get what Ronaldo was that season. Proof of this was his unforgettable goal against Compostela. Receiving the ball in his own half, Ronaldo slalomed his way to goal at full speed and powerful solo run. Defenders tried to foul him, stop him, but no one could get near him. And Sir Bobby Robson's reaction was the cherry on top. It was an unforgettable goal that encapsulates Ronaldo in his entire 96-97 season. An impressive showing of football that feels like a preview trailer of what Leo Messi would do on the regular 10 years in the future. Ronaldo would score 47 goals in 49 matches, and that wasn't enough for Barcelona to lift the La Liga title. Prime Ronaldo was a striker like no other that combined the best elements of the players you love today. For many pundits, his knees were the only obstacle in his path to becoming the best player in history. Ronaldo was so big and so ill-advised that he felt Barcelona was, again, too small for him. The Serie A was, at the time, the league with the best strikers in the world, and Inter Milan paid a then-world-record $27 million. That move was a career-defining one for more reasons than one. A split in the story of Ronaldo, one that separates his history and his game in two. In his first Serie A season, Ronaldo continued being unstoppable. His impressive game earned him his first Ballon d'Or, and the red carpet was laid out for him to be the star in the 1998 World Cup. But in the final,
eu não lembro direito. Sei que eu dormi. Como o doutor disse, parece que foi uma convulsão de 30, 40 segundos. Mas nesse período eu acordei cheio de dor no corpo. Mas com o passar do tempo estava melhorando, as dores estavam sumindo, já estava mais relaxado, quer dizer, mas precisava dos exames. Eu tentei de tudo para ajudar a seleção brasileira, mas infelizmente o jogo, eles entraram bem e jogaram melhor do que a gente.
Soon after, his knees gave up. Ronaldo was forced to be sidelined for a full 2 years. While such a blow might kill another player's career, not Ronaldo. The Brazilian reinvented himself, playing in a more central role in the box. He became deadlier and smarter, joining Real Madrid, winning the 2002 World Cup and a second Ballon d'Or. But that's a story for another time. This was the legend of the early years of the original Ronaldo, a force of nature, capable of scoring 145 club goals in just 153 games. The first PlayStation player. And the biggest difference with Ronaldo and Cristiano Ronaldo and Messi was this. At the time, there was no argument. He simply was the best player around. Now you know why Sorare decided to release its first legend card of R9 by using the 94-95 season. Many more Sorare legend cards are available for you to collect. Find them by clicking the link in the description. The early years of Ronaldo, the phenomenon, have an incredible number of similarities with another Brazilian striker who impressed the world, conquering the Dutch League with PSV and moving on to shock La Liga with FC Barcelona. We are talking about Romario. In this video, you'll find out just how good the little Brazilian striker actually was.